Father, we thank you for the Bible study today.
Baba wa dupe lowo yin fun eko bibeli toni.
Thank you for calling us to wisdom and to faith.
A dupe lowo yin pe npe wa sinu ogbon ati sinu igbagbo.
It is wisdom that makes the right choice in life.
Ogbon ni mu ni yan to da ninu aye yi.
And yet we can only make that choice by faith.
A si le yan nkan to da na nipa igbagbo.
We pray, O Lord, you'll open our understanding today so we can see very clearly the path you are setting before us, and so that we can make the choice and take the decision by faith in Jesus' name.
An gbadura Oluwa wi pe ki e la wa loju ninu oro yin loni ki a ba le ri ipa ti o wa ni waju wa ki a si le yan to dara ni oruko Jesus.
Our decisions determine a lot in our lives.
Ipinu wa o ni se pelu ige aye wa lopo.
Determines a lot in our families.
Opolopo nkan lo ni se pelu ebi
wa. Determines a lot for our children.
O ni se pelu ige aye awon
omo. Determines a lot for our future on earth.
O ni se pelu ojo waju wa.
Is a lot for us even in eternity. And so we pray that you grant us the faith to make the right choice in life in Jesus' name. If we will walk as seeing the invisible one, if we will have eternity in view every time, it will not be difficult to make the choice of faith. And so we pray, O Lord, you help us to make this choice, this determination to have faith before us, within us, in everything that we do, every time, in Jesus' name.
We're
praying, O Lord, as to help the people we're going to read about today, you will help every one of us in Jesus' name. Fix our heart, fix our eyes on you. Help us to remain firm in the Lord. We pray that the decisions we take will not ruin us, but will help us. In Jesus' name we pray. By the grace of God, we are making progress in our study of the Epistle to the Hebrews.
We have
been on Hebrews chapter 11 for some time now. And the Lord has been leading us to study in details from verses 1 to verse 22. And we are taking these verses, a little at a time, so that we will not just run through within a short time and yet miss the great, great lessons preserved for us in the Word of God. Today we're looking at verses 23 to
26.
And these verses are actually talking about faith as well as decisions. And so the title of our subject today, the decisions of faith. I need to tell you that every one of us, we are taking decisions every day. There is no day that passes that we do not take decisions.
They
may be the regular, normal daily decisions that we take in life. And those decisions determine where we will be tomorrow. In fact, where we are today. Who we are today. What we're doing today.
It's
a result of the decisions we took yesterday. What we will be tomorrow will be the result of the decisions we are taking today. In fact, our destiny, our eternity depends on the decisions we take in time and in life. Decisions determine destiny. And our decisions have far-reaching effects upon us and upon many other people around us. Today we happen to be studying about about the decisions of Moses and the decisions of the parents of Moses. Look at it in Hebrews chapter 11 from verse 23. By faith Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents, because they saw that he was a proper child, and they were not afraid of the king's commandment.
Nipa igbagbo ni awon obi Mose pa mo fun osu meta nigbati abi nitori ti won ri ni arewa omo won ko si beru ase oba.
They had to take a decision.
Won lati se ipinu.
And the decisions that the parents of Moses took affected Moses obviously.
Ipinu ti awon obi Mose si se o ni se lori igbe aye Mose.
Not only that it affected Moses, it affected the nation of Israel.
Ki se lori Mose nikan ni ipinu iduro le lori o tun ni se pelu igbe aye awon Israeli.
It was that decision that provided a deliverer for the nation of Israel.
Ipinu ti won se o lo se
the decisions you take have far-reaching effect upon the children in your family. Your decisions can ruin your children. And your decisions can make your children deliverers for the nation. In verse 24, by faith Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. Again, Moses himself had to make a decision. And his decisions affected him, and of course it affected the nation of Israel. Without the decisions that we're reading about today, we would have had nothing about Moses.
There
are some good decisions in your life that history will write about. Better than your name even written in the books of men, your name will be in the book of life, and some things will be written in heaven on your record because of the decisions you are taking today. As a result of that decision taken by the parents and by Moses, Israel was delivered from bondage. God's covenant with Abraham was fulfilled. The power of God was made known in Egypt. The revelation of God was put down in written form by Moses to be made known to the whole world. Our decisions will reveal who we are. I will determine whether we'll be useful or we're going to be useless. Our decisions will determine where we're going to spend eternity. In fact, it's more than that. Our decisions may determine where the people around us, the people we influence, will spend eternity. Seemingly simple and important decisions that we take that will have great consequences in our lives and in the lives of other people.
And you
either take your decision in faith or you take your decision in fear.
But
the decisions that are taken in fear, taken in unbelief, taken because of negative reaction to what other people are doing, what other people are saying, how other people are acting, the decisions you take in reaction to what other people are doing will determine where you will spend eternity.
Ipinu ti a ba si wa se ninu iberu tabi ta se ninu igbagbo ninu aigbagbo tabi ta se ninu iwa si pe bawo lawon eyan se nko bi ara si mi ati pe kini awon eyan wi nipa mi iru ipinu yen ni yo pinu boya ayeraye wa yo dara
ta ko dara. Those decisions actually amount to us committing spiritual suicide.
Awon ipinu ti a si se won yi ngba mi o ma nyori si pe ka pokun so nipa ti emi.
Decisions were taken anger.
Awon ipinu ta ba se ninu ibinu.
Decisions were taken when we are frustrated. Decisions we take when we're trying to revenge. Eventually, these decisions have an effect upon our lives, and it will appear we're even cutting off our own spiritual link with the Lord, and we commit spiritual suicide by those decisions that we're taking.
Iru awon ipinu wonyi ele ti a se niru ko be yo tile se akoba igbesi aye wa debi pe yo fi opin si ibasepo ti nbe laarin awa ati Olorun.
There will be no regret in our lives when we take our decisions with God.
Koni si abamo kankan ninu aye wa nigba ta ba se ipinu pelu
Olorun. And we consult God before we take our decisions.
Ti a si bere lowo Olorun ko to di pa se
ipinu. That's the difference between Saul and David.
Elei ni iyato to nbe laarin
Saul ati David. Both of them had many decisions to take in life.
Awon mejeji won ni ipinu lati se
ninu aye yi. Saul never consulted the Lord in taking decisions. But David was also always consulting the Lord in taking a step, in taking a decision. As we look at what we're looking at today, we're looking at some deep, deep, profound things in the Word of God. And please pay attention as we look at the verses of Scripture. Divided into three parts. Number one, protection received by faith. Number two, privilege rejected by faith. Number three, pleasure refused by faith. Let's look at number one. Protection received by faith. In Hebrews chapter 11 verse 23. It says, by faith Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents because they saw that he was a proper child, and they were not afraid of the king's commandment.
Only nipa igbagbo ni awon obi Mose pa mo fun osun meta nigba ti a bi nitori won ri ni arewo omo won ko si beru ase oba.
We need to read the story in Exodus chapter 1 and Exodus chapter 2.
Agbodo ka itan na ninu Exodus ori kini ati ori
keji. And I want you to be able to picture and visualize what was happening at that time.
Mo si fe ko ma foju inu wo ohun to sele nigba na.
And see everything that was being done and see the action of the father and the mother of Moses.
Yo si ri bi won se se nigba na ati ko wo iwa si ise baba ati iya Moses.
And then see the faith in the actions of those parents. And see how they got protection from the Lord for themselves and for their children, and for Moses in particular, by faith. In Exodus chapter 1 verse 16. And he said, when ye do the office of a midwife unto the Hebrew women, and see them upon the stools, if it be a son, then ye shall kill him. But if it be a daughter, then shall he live.
O si wi pe nigba ti eyin ba nse ise iya agba fun awon obirin eberu ti eyin ba ri won ni ikunle bi o ba se omokunrin ni nje ki eyin ki o pa.
The situation we're looking at, you remember, the Jacob and all his children have entered into Egypt. Joseph was an honored, exalted man in Egypt. But not many years have passed. Another king rose up in Egypt. This one did not know Joseph. And he began to see that these children of Israel, they were growing stronger and stronger. He became afraid of them. And he began to imagine that these children of Israel, they were going to grow into a multitude, and they were going to be strong, and eventually they will escape from the land of Egypt. Actually, what he was thinking was the plan of the Lord, that the children of Israel will increase in number, they will increase in strength, and they will not remain in Egypt forever. The Lord will take them out of the land of Egypt and take them to their own land. They will be a separate nation.
Ohun ti o ro o se dede pelu eti Olorun fun awon omo Israeli pe ni to awon omo Israeli won o gberu won o di alagbara won o di orilede This king
did not want that plan of God for Israel to be fulfilled. So he raised up a negative strategy that all the babies that were being born, if they were boys, they'll be destroyed. If they were daughters, they should leave them and allow them to live. What's the implication of that? It will mean that as years will be coming and going, the older people will be dying. Eventually, there will be no men preserved related to the children of Israel. The rest of the people related to Israel will be daughters. They will be married to the people of Egypt, and then they will never be a separate nation. They will never leave the land of Egypt. They will just be forgotten completely, and Egypt alone will remain.
On to ma je abajade eleyi ni pe nigba to ba di pe awon ti won je agbalagba lokunrin ti won ba ku tan leyin ore yin awon ti won iba tu dide leyin won gba won ba ti pa won yo wa je pe kikida awon omo birin ni yo ku ti yo je omo Israeli awon omo ara Egypt won si ma gbe awon omo Israeli ni yawo de bi pe eti Olorun lati so won di orilede ti won awadin to mofo.
And then when Pharaoh saw that the midwives were not doing what he said, he commanded everybody in Egypt, if you see any Israelite having a baby and that baby is a boy, you must kill that baby.
Nigbati Pharaoh wa ri pe ohun to npa lase fun awon iya agba I pe ki won o se fun awon obirin to nrobi ni Israeli won o se o wa pase kari aye fun gbogbo awon eyan na I pe ti won ba sa ti foju gan ni omokunrin to je omo owo ki won pa iru omo be.
Chapter 1 verse 22.
Ori kini ese ikejile
lo. Pharaoh charged all his people, all the Egyptians, saying, every son that is born ye shall cast into the river, and every daughter ye shall save alive.
Pharaoh si pase fun gbogbo awon eniyan re wi pe gbogbo omokunrin ti tabi oni ki eyin gbeju sinu odo gbogbo awon omobirin ni ki eyin ki o da si.
You see the conflict, you see the problem, you see the confusion in which they were.
O wa le ri iru iporuru ati wahala ele ti won wa nu re
bayi. And it was after that time, with that edict on, with that strategy to destroy the children of Israel, with everything on, that the father and the mother of Moses got married.
Ni akoko igba ti ofin yi le ti o gbogbo nkan won yin sele ni ile Egypt nigba yen gan ni baba ati ya Moses ni won se
pe ya. Chapter 2 verse 1, and there went a man of the house of Levi, and he took to wife a daughter of Levi.
Ori keji ese ikini okunrin kan ara Levi si lo o si fe omobirin Levi kan.
Now you will see here that they got married at that difficult time. Isn't that an action of faith? At such a difficult time, there are people that will use their common sense and they will say, what's the point in getting married? Because if we get married and we have any baby that's a boy, that child is going to be destroyed. And how can we bear the Egyptians taking our child and throwing it to the river or killing that baby mercilessly? There is no point getting married. You see the people that are walking by sight, they will not take such an action at such a time. That's why their action, their decision to even get married was an action, a decision of faith.
O je me pe iru akoko bayi o ni awon eyan ma nlo ogbon ori won ti won ni ngba ta ti e ba fe sabatile se gbeyawo bayi ta ba bimo se a o laju wa sile korokoro bayi ti awon ara Egypt yo ma gba wa lomo e to ba jokunrin ni won ti won a de pa ni ipa ika loju wa bayi.
Chapter 2 verse 2, and the woman conceived and bare a son, and when she saw him to be a goodly child, she hid him 3 months.
O si bi omokunrin kan nigba ti o si ri pe o se omo didara o pa mo ni osu meta.
Here we understand wisdom goes along with faith.
Ni lati gbe ri pe ogbon o ma dapo mo igbagbo.
But the decision was to hide this child.
Ipinu won ni lati pa omo na mo.
And that the Egyptians will not take this child and they will not throw this child into the river.
Ki owo se ku awon ara Egypt ma ba te omo na ko ma ba so si odo.
And this action was taken by faith.
Won si se ipinu yi nipa igbagbo.
And then after hiding the child for 3 months, then she could not hide the child again. In verse 3, when she could no longer hide him, she took for him an ark of bulrushes and daubed it with slime and with pitch and put the child therein, and she laid it in the flax by the river spring.
O si fi oda ile ati o je igi san I'm sure you know
the story. This is what is being referred to, and the Bible is giving us the comment of the Holy Ghost about it, that she did all this with the consent of the father of that child of Moses, and both of them did it by faith.
Baba Mose, lati lojo fowo
fowo see what the Bible is saying about it in Acts of the Apostles chapter 7.
Iwo wo nti Bible nso nipa re ninu ise awon aposteli
orikeje. Chapter 7 reading from verse 18.
Ninu ise awon aposteli orikeje ese ikejide
nuko. Understand that this was a major decision in that family.
O ri pe ipinu eti o se pataki ninu ebi yi.
And that major decision was taken by faith.
A si se ipinu to se pataki nipa igbagbo.
Are there not decisions you have to take in your family?
Se ko wa si awon ipinu ti wa se ninu ebi.
Are there not decisions you need to take in your personal life?
There
are people that just decide, it's like they just toss a coin, head or tail, and whether it is head or tail, then they just move ahead and take a decision. They ruin their lives. Other people, if they are not happy about something, that sorrow of heart, that suffering in the heart, that affliction in the heart, they also, you know, take a decision and say, that's what I'm going to do. I don't care what will happen. You made discover that you are throwing yourself into the jaws of the devil by that kind of decision you are taking.
Awon elomiran ti ba si ni iporuru tabi pe won ni ibanuje kan nu okan won lori nkan ti o ba sele si won lori iyen ni won fi fi iwara se ipinu ele to si je pe won fari ya won fa kekori ngba won ba si se ru ipinu be won so ara won si
your decisions by faith.
Sugbon lati se ipinu nipa igbagbo.
Have eternity in view.
Ki o gbe aye raje
iye ka waju. Have the word of God in view.
Let
God be by your side and let God counsel you as you are taking that decision. Don't walk by sight, walk by faith as you are taking those major decisions in your life.
Acts
of the Apostles chapter 7 and verse 18. Till another king arose which knew not Joseph, and he sent them subtilly with our kindred and evil entreated our father, so that they cast out their young children to the end, that is for the purpose that they might not live.
Oh na ni o se arekereke si awon ibatan wa won si wa buburu si awon baba wa to be ti won fi ja awon omo won kuro lowo won nitori ki won ki o ma le se ye.
Verse 20, in which time Moses was born and was exceedingly fear and nourished up in his father's house 3 months.
Ni ese ogun ni akoko na ni asibi Mose eni ti o ni ewa pupo.
You see here, they saw the beauty. And they saw the beauty of this little baby. They
Lord
ministered to their heart. That this is not ordinary beauty. This child is going to do something significant and beautiful for the kingdom of God. And every time they looked at the child, it's like this masterpiece is coming from the hand of the Almighty God. How can anybody throw this one away? This is a significant child. God cannot do a marvelous work like this and make a marvelous creation like this and give us a good child like this just for nothing. There is something beyond this physical beauty. God is going to use this child in a marvelous way, and we're going to be following the Lord by faith.
Ki o wa je pe iru omo be ni a wa pa nipa kupa lati owo awon ara Egypt. Daju daju Olorun fe lu omo e fun kankan ni.
And then in verse 21, and when he was cast out, that is when they made that basket and they put that child by the riverside, Pharaoh's daughter took him up and nourished him for her own son.
Ese ikokanlelogun nigba ti won si gbe sonu yen ni pe nigba ti won te sinu akoti Yesu ti won gbe lo si eti omi yi.
Why didn't the parents of Moses act in fear? Why didn't they surrender their child Moses to be killed by the cruel edict? And the Bible tells us that they took their action by faith. You find that comment of the Holy Ghost concerning their action in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 23. It says by by faith, Moses, when he was born, was he 3 months of his parents.
He
said, because they saw that he was a proper child, a good child, a significant child, and they knew that whatever will happen, God has a hand in this, and this child will not lose his life like this. He will do a significant thing for the nation. Because of that, they used their faith and they kept the child.
And
divine protection was given to the child because the parents acted in faith. If you are parents, if you have children, what will become of those children that you have will depend upon your faith in God today. The decisions to take about those children will determine a lot of things in their lives. And if you do not take your decisions by faith and you take your decisions by sight, you might ruin these children.
But
they took care of that child by faith. They trained that child by faith. And eventually that child became a significant person because of the faith of the parents. The strong supernatural spiritual faith that they had in God sustained them in the time, in the hour of crisis. Their faith in God overcame the fear of man. It is faith that makes us to look away from human terrors, to put our trust in the invisible God. In times of persecution, the promises of God are the greatest protection for us if we truly believe the Lord. See what the Bible says at the latter part of that verse 23. It says, and they were not afraid of the king's commandment. They were not afraid of the king's commandment. Fear ruins us. The fear of in-laws, the fear of our own parents, the fear of the society around us, the fear of what the idol worshippers are saying, if you don't make this sacrifice, this will happen, the fear of the threats of our relatives, bring that child to the village, give us that child, you be going to your church, but this child, your first child belongs to our family, therefore bring that child. The fear of what they will do if you don't do what they are saying, that fear can ruin you and ruin that child.
The fear of what they were
not afraid. In Psalm 56, in God I will praise his word. In God I will put my trust. I will not fear what flesh can do unto me.
Nipa Olorun ni emi o ma yin oro re. Olorun ni emi o gbeke mi le emi ki o beru kini ele rara yo se.
Look at verse 11 of that same psalm. In God I have put my trust. I will not be afraid what man can do unto me.
Wo we se kokanla ori kan na yi. Olorun ni emi gbeke mi le emi ki o beru kini eyan le se si mi.
Whether that man is a herbalist or not, I will not fear what the herbalist man will do unto me.
Bi eni e ba tle je ada nse tabi o je babalawo mi o ni beru ti eyan le se.
The idol worshippers, I will not fear what the idol worshipper, the man, can do unto me.
Eni e je aborisha nko ni beru ohun ti aborisha kan le se si mi.
All they are violent people, aggressive people that everybody is afraid of. I will live my life by faith. I will not live by the fear of any man. I shall not fear what man can do unto me.
Abi iru eni be je ijaje eniyan alagidi tabi oni wahala eniyan. Iru eni be gbogbo eyan le ma beru re sugbe emi ki o beru re tori pe emi ki o
Psalm 118 verse 6, the Lord is on my side. If you are on the Lord's side, the Lord will be on your side. If you take your decision by faith, the Lord will be on your side. If you are resting and leaning upon the promises of the Lord will be on your side. If you see this child a beautiful child, and you know that God could not have done this by mistake, even though there is poverty, even though there is no food, even though there is any contrary thing, I know that God is on my side. You'll be able to take every decision relating to this child by faith.
Your
child has been going to school.
Your
child is doing well. And you know, this is not for nothing. All of a sudden you just calculate, I don't have money. And within 1 minute, 5 minutes, it's almost like somebody has mental problems.
You
just take a decision. Child, sit at home, you'll not go to school again. There is no money. Is that a decision of faith? Are you not walking by sight? Will not your decision ruin the life of this child? How do you know what God will provide tomorrow? Your decision can turn a child that ought to be a doctor in future, that ought to be a deliverer in future, that ought to be saving the lives of people in future, and make that fellow an illiterate that does not know left from right. Be careful of the decisions you are taking upon the children.
Psalm 118 verse 6,
the Lord is on my side. If you are a believer, why don't you realize the Lord is on your side? Whatever the edict of Pharaoh, why don't you understand the Lord is on your side? Whatever the Egyptians have been commanded to do to all the children that have been born, why don't you understand the Lord is on your side? If the Lord is on your side, this helpless baby that can only cry today will be the one that will confuse and shake the whole of Egypt. Will be the one that will manifest the power of God in the land of Egypt. Will be the one that will silence all the magicians of Egypt. Will be the one that will turn their water into blood. He will be the one, this helpless baby, this helpless child that we're hiding today, and it appears that everybody is afraid. What will happen to this child? If we can decide in faith concerning every detail in the life of this child tomorrow will open the Red Sea for millions to pass over.
The edict of Egypt
did not last, but Moses survived. The problem that is troubling your heart today will not last, but the purpose of God in your life will last.
So,
the Lord is on your side. I will not fear what man can do unto me. Man can do nothing unto you. What did Jesus say? Jesus said, be not afraid, only believe. No money, be not afraid, only believe. The child is deformed, be not afraid, only believe. The child is so sick, we don't know the child will ever live. Don't kill the child, don't do anything to the child. Be not afraid, only believe.
In
the condition of the the child is even bringing shame to us now. Look at this child. Every time we see the child, we are wondering, isn't it better for this child to die? Don't talk like that. Don't touch that child. Take your decisions by faith and live in the presence of God. The Lord is on your side. Leave that child in the hand of the Lord. That child will become somebody significant tomorrow in Jesus' name.
Now we go to
point number two. Prestige rejected by faith.
And
we're looking at it now in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 24. By faith Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. What a bold decision Moses had to take. And you see now, Moses that was being hidden for those 3 months is no more a hidden child now.
And
Pharaoh claimed Moses to be her daughter. And Moses had the greatest education anybody could have. He had liberty and freedom in the land of Egypt. Everybody was thinking about him as in the royal family. Because actually after the Pharaoh that was living then, that daughter of Pharaoh should have been on the throne, but a woman could not be their ruler and their leader at that time, could not be a Pharaoh, and therefore the daughter was looking at Moses that if I don't make it because I'm a woman, because there was no other son in that family, Moses was the one that will then reign over Egypt.
But
when Moses looked at that privilege, he rejected that privilege. He refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. That was a bold, bold decision, courageous decision that can only be taken by faith, only taken by the people that see the spiritual heights God was calling them to. To reject such a privilege, to reject such prestige as Moses rejected, demands real faith in God.
Another
reasoning would have said, why don't you take that position? You can take that position and use that position to reform Egypt.
And
there are people that are thinking like that. They are thinking that, why don't I take that position? That chieftaincy title, that political position, to reform the world. You cannot reform the world. You cannot reform Egypt. Egypt is what it is. The world is what it is. Listen to the voice of God and know what the Lord is calling you to.
Oh, letu aye she, oh letu Egypt she. Sorry, pe bi Egypt she jebe na lunge. Be aye she jebe na niwange. Sorry, na peti se itoni olorun.
Other people might have reason. Why don't you take that position and you will lessen the oppression that they are putting upon the Israelites?
Awo elomi amaro. Pe kilo deto ba iko yen ko ba le fokun si ipeju awon omo Israeli.
That was not the purpose of God.
Iyan o ki se eto olorun.
He didn't want the oppression to be lessened in Egypt, because then the children of Israel will relax. They will stay there. They will never think of going out of Egypt.
It
was when the affliction was much on them, when the oppression was much on them, they began to cry unto the Lord to get out of Egypt.
ti wahala ti inira inira yen po fun won ni won bere si ni pe pe olorun lati jade ni
Other people will say, why don't you accept that privilege and you will escape much suffering, much affliction.
Awon elomiran so pe ki lo de to gba anfani yi ki o ba le bo kuro nu wahala ati
iya. But Moses understood that the Egyptians that had that privilege and they escape affliction on earth, they will have that affliction and multiple fold in eternity.
Also, Moses wa mo pe awon ara Egypt ti won gba anfani yen ti o je pe won bo kuro nu wahala ati aye yi ni won je oke imoye iya nigba ti o ba de aye
raye. You see what Moses did? He put the privilege that he had in Egypt and the privilege God was calling him to, he put everything in the balance and he saw that what God was telling him to do, what God was giving him, was greater than what Egypt was telling him to have.
O wa rin ti Moses se ngba na iyen ni pe anfani ti Egypt ti a fi ro pe ko wa gba ati anfani ipe ti Olorun pe si o ko mejeji sori osuwon o wa ri pe ipe ti Olorun pe si o tewon ju anfani Egypt lo.
Only bold faith in God can make us to reject scholarship from Satan.
Kiki igbagbo eti o ni igboya ninu olo le mu wa ko eti didi se
ipo ti Satan ni. People that Satan wants to give them scholarship.
Awon elomiran kan wa to je pe esu fe fun won lopo.
And he's telling them, look at greatness.
Oni ewo nkan to ga.
I can make you great.
Mo le so de ni
la. I can lead you to that great place.
Mo le fi o si ipo giga
aye yi. And I give you scholarship, everything free of charge, and I get you there.
Ki si fun won ni nkan ofe pe ko le de ipo giga
na. It is only faith in God that makes us to reject the scholarship coming from the devil that will promote us to greatness, and we want to wait for the time of God.
Kiki igbagbo ninu Olorun oni yo mu wa tako nkan ofe tin bo latodo Satani eti yo si mu wa tako ife Olorun.
That's the decision that Moses took in his life.
Elei ni ipinu ti Moses se ninu aye
re. In Acts of the Apostles chapter 7.
Ninu ise awon apostle ori keje.
Reading from verse 21.
Ti abaka ese ikokan
le. And when he was cast out, Pharaoh's daughter took him up and nourished him for her own son.
Nigba ti won si gbe sonu omobirin Pharaoh he o si to dagba ni omo ara.
Moses was learned in all the wisdom of the Egyptians and was mighty in words and in deeds. And when he was full 40 years old, it came into his heart to visit his brethren. He associated with them, he identified with them, he knew them that they were his brethren. He did not put himself to be identified with the Egyptians. It was in his heart to visit his brethren, the children of Israel.
O so si lokan lati lo bi awon omo Israeli ara re wo iyen ni pe o ma ara re gege bi akan lara awon omo Israeli o fara re so mo won be ni ko fara re ma awon ara Egypt.
That's the kind of thing we learn about Paul the apostle too.
Nti akoko nipa ibi aye Paul apostle
ni pe the choice of faith.
O se ipinu igbagbo.
The decision of faith.
O pinu igbagbo.
That made him to reject the privileges of being part of the Sanhedrin.
Eto mu ki o ko anfani pe ko wa lara awon igbimo Sanhedrin
sile. And the prestige of being a Pharisee at that time.
Ati ipo la pe ke ye wa lara awon
Pharisee gbana. He rejected everything so that he could follow the way of the law.
O ko gbogbo awon nkan won sile ko ba le ton Oluwa.
It is not very common today among the people that say they are Christians.
Ko wopo ninu aye opolopo awon tan jewo
Christian loni. Because they were looking for prosperity at any cost.
Awon Christian ti won wa asike ati oro ni gbogbo ona.
They're looking for children at any cost.
Won wa mo ni gbogbo ibi ti e ba
si le. They're looking for wife at any cost.
Won wa aya ni gbogbo ona.
They're wanting to get a wife at an husband at any cost.
Won fe ni oko nigba pe ni gbogbo.
They want promotion in their places of work at any price.
Won wa igbega ni bi ise won ni gbogbo ti o ba
lo. And even when the thing is coming from Satan.
Nigba ti nkan yen ba ti en bo lati odo Satan.
And it's coming from agents of Satan.
O si n bo lati odo
ise Satan. And they know that this is not coming from the right direction.
Sawon fura won de mo pe kini yi to n bo yi ko to ko
to na. They still take that thing.
Won si tewo gba nkan
yi. Because they do not realize we have to reject all those things coming through Satan, and the agents of Satan will reject them by faith.
Tori pe won o mo pe ise lo ye ka tako tabi ka ko gbogbo awon nkan to ba nbo lati odo esu ati awon amugbalegbe.
Some Christians just say I'm born again.
Awon Christian ka so pe mo ti
da. But there is no consecration that will say this thing, although they call it a privilege, this thing they call it prestige, this thing they call it position, this thing they call it power, it's not coming from the right direction. If I'm going to have anything, it will come from God. I reject this one by faith.
Iru awon eni be won o ni ise ra eni to bege ele to fi je pe won o fi le tako gbogbo nkan to ba je bi ipo ola abi nkan bi ipo giga tabi igbega kan le to je pe lati odo satani lo ti nbo.
Philippians chapter 3 verse 4.
Ninu Philippi oriketa ese ikeri.
Though I might also have confidence in the flesh, if any other man thinketh that he has whereof he might trust in the flesh, I more.
Bi emi ti kara mi tile ni igbekele ninu ara bi enikan ba ro pe o ni igbekele ninu ara temi tile ju.
Circumcised the eighth day of the stock of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, and Hebrew of the Hebrews, as touching the law a Pharisee.
Eni ti akonila ni jokejo lati inu kukute Israeli wa, lati inu eya Benjamini, eberu lati inu eberu wa, ni ti ofin Pharisee li emi.
Concerning zeal, persecuting the church, touching the righteousness, which is in the law, blameless.
Ni ti itara emi nse inu ni bini si ijo, ni ti ododo ti o wa ni inu ofin moji ala ilegan.
But what things were gain to me, those I counted loss for Christ.
Sugbon ohunkohun ti o ja si ere fun mi awon ni mo ka si ofo nitori Christ.
Now you can see the decision that Moses took.
O le ri ipinu ti Moses se.
And you can see the decision that Paul the apostle took.
O si le ri ipinu ti Paul apostle se
pelu. And those were bold decisions of faith.
Awon eyi si je ipinu igbagbo.
Actually, man is known by the kind of decisions he makes.
A ma mo eniyan nipa iru ipinu to ba se.
You cannot know a man fully until you know what he accepts and what he can reject by faith.
Oh, le mo bi eyan se je lai je ko ba mo nti iru eni be le gba tabi nti iru eni be le ko nipa igbagbo.
It is when you see what a man can reject and say nothing looks good, not everything that glitters is good, I cannot have that, I know where it's coming from, I refuse that, I reject that, then you know what kind of man that individual is.
Oh, le mo enikan nigba ti iru eni be to ba ni anfani kankan kan to iru eni be wa koru nkan be to ni ki se gbogbo nkan to n deni wura pe mo pinu pe lati yan ife Olorun ju ati tele nkan won e lo iru igba yen la fi ma ru
eni. When you have a particular problem, advisors will be coming from left and right.
Nigba to ba wa nu wahala kan awon abanidaro won ma wa lotu.
When they give you those pieces of advice, what you reject, what you accept, will show the kind of man, the kind of woman you are.
Iru imoran ti o ba wa fun o nigba na e ti o ba gba nu re e ti o ba konu re o lo ma juwe iru eni to je
gan. Our spiritual life is measured by the daily decisions we are taking.
Igbe aye wa nipa ti emi o la n se odiwon re nipa ipinu ta n se lojojumo.
They don't know how to say no to their neighbors.
Awon kan wa to je pe won o ma ba se so pe be ko fun
awon. They don't know how to say no to backsliders who may be counseling them.
Won o ma ba ti so pe be ko fun awon apada seyin to ba gba won nimoran.
They don't know how to say no to the people who are ignorant of the word of God, who are telling them, what's the matter with you, why don't you do this, why don't you do this, why don't you choose this, why don't you go this direction. They do not have the faith that can say no to the agents of Satan.
Won o ma ba ti so pe be ko fun awon eniyan ti won o moro Olorun iru awon ton gba won nimoran pe ki lo de to rin bayi ki lo de to gba bayi bawo lo se dogbon si bayi won o ma ba se ko furu awon ti won ja agbenu so fun satani be.
A man of faith, a woman of faith, will keep eternity in view all the time.
Eni ti o ba je eni igbagbo yala lokunrin tabi lobirin re ni be agbe aye
ayi kawaju re bayi. You will reject the privileges and prestige of this passing world that will soon fade away.
Yo si ko gbogbo awon ipo ola ati gbogbo awon nkan mere mere nu aye yi ti ko ni ba
ko ra. You know what Moses realized? He realized that if he remained in the palace and enjoyed everything that the palace of Egypt offered him, he'll be out of the will of God.
Oh, man ti Mose ro, ohun to ro ni pe ti o ba wa ninu afin ti o ba n gbadun laafin ohun yo padanu gbogbo ese ti Olorun ni fun igbese aye o.
If you will believe God as Moses believed the law,
ti iwo na yo ba gba Olorun gbo bi Moses
gba Olorun, you will find it easy to decide and to choose what he chose, what he decided.
Yo ro won na lorun lati le se ipinu iru ipinu ti ohun fun ra ese.
And in Psalm 84,
ninu orin Davidi Olorun ile merin anka ese ile,
you will see the choice of a righteous man,
wari iyan olododo,
the decision of a man of faith,
ipinu eni igbagbo.
In Psalm 84 verse 10,
ninu orin Davidi orin ikerinlelogorin
ese kewa, it says there, for a day in thy court is better than a thousand.
Nitori pe ojo kan ninu agbala re san ju egberun ojo lo.
I had rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness.
Mo fe ki n kuku ma se adena ni ile Olorun mi ju lati ma gbe ago iwa buburu.
There are some people today, they say they are born again. If they are inviting them for chieftaincy title in their village, and then they consider it, they say, well, if I'm a highly placed person there, I'm a chief in my village, the honor that is going to give, I can even use that for the church. because if I'm a chief in the village, I can easily get land, I will give it to the church, many advantages for the church. They'll be looking at material things. They will not see that idolatry is connected. They will not see that traditions of men are connected. They will not see that the devil is behind it. They'll say, I take it. It will even be for the glory of God. If you're a real Christian, you'll know how to reject such things by faith.
Àwọn kan wà lónìí tí wọ́n sọ pé wọ́n ti di àtòbí. Irú àwọn ènìyàn bẹ́ẹ̀ tí wọ́n bá kọ̀wé sí wọn láti abúlé wọn pé wọ́n fẹ́ fi wọ́n joyè pàtàkì kan. Irú àwọn ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ wọn ò ní mọ̀ bá ti sọ pé bẹ́ẹ̀ kọ́ fúrú àwọn tí wọ́n fẹ́ fi wọ́n joyè torí pé wọ́n á mọ dàrú ònú ọkàn wọn pé tí n bá kú títẹ̀ gba oyè yìí màá lè lo oyè yẹn fún ògo ọlọ́run. Irú ilẹ̀ lábúlé wa tí n bá sọ pé ilẹ̀ báyìí ni mò ń fẹ́ wá fún mi ní ilẹ̀ bẹ́ẹ̀ tó bá jẹ́ pé nǹkan kan mo nawọ́ sí wá fún mi láti lè lò fún ìjọ ọlọ́run. Wọn ò ní mọ̀ pé ìbọ̀rìṣà ní ṣe pẹ̀lú oyè tí wọ́n fẹ́ fi wọ́n jẹ. Wọn ò sì ní tún mọ̀ pé àwọn àṣà ìbílẹ̀ àti oríṣiríṣi àwọn ìwà ìbàjẹ́ ló wà ní oyè tí wọ́n fẹ́ jẹ. Wọn ò ní mọ̀ bá ṣe sọ pé bẹ́ẹ̀ kọ́ fún sátánì.
Let's look at point number 3 now.
Ẹ jẹ́ kí a wo kókó kẹta báyìí.
Pleasure refused by faith.
Kíkọ ìgbádùn ayé sílẹ̀ nípa ìgbàgbọ́.
And you see many of the things that people are battling with.
O mọ̀ pé ohun tí ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ àwọn èèyàn ń kó rárá.
It is because they do not have faith in God.
Ìdí ni pé wọn ò ní ìgbàgbọ́ nínú Ọlọ́run.
It is faith that overcomes the flesh.
Ìgbàgbọ́ ni mọ́ mú ní ṣẹ́gun ẹran.
It is faith that overcomes the world.
Ìgbàgbọ́ ni mú ní ṣẹ́gun ayé yìí.
It is faith that refuses the pleasure of the flesh.
Ìgbàgbọ́ ni mọ́ mú ní kọ ìgbádùn ayé sílẹ̀.
But it is unbelief that makes us to be looking back.
Ṣùgbọ́n àìgbàgbọ́ ni mọ́ mú wa bojú wẹ̀yìn.
Regretting that we had consecrated our lives to the Lord.
Ìní mọ́ mú yàn kábàámọ̀ pé a ti fi ayé wa jù
fún Ọlọ́run. It is unbelief that makes us to see all the pleasure of the world and the pleasure of the flesh that I've missed. Why did I take that foolish decision? Why don't I enjoy myself? That's not faith, that's unbelief.
Àìgbàgbọ́ ni mọ́ mú yàn fìkà àpamọ́ bọnú pé ewo nú ayé tí mo ti fi sílẹ̀ ewo gbogbo àwọn àǹfààní ìgbádùn tí mo kọ̀ sílẹ̀ torí pé mo yan ọ̀nà ìgbàlà yìí. Àìgbàgbọ́ ni mọ́ mú yàn ké irú àbámọ̀ bẹ́ẹ̀.
It is unbelief that makes us to forget eternity and forget heaven.
Àìgbàgbọ́ ni mọ́ mú yàn gbàgbé nípa ayérayé àti ìjọba
Ọlọ́run. It is unbelief that makes us to drop our head and be crying and be thinking and be meditating. See all the privileges I've lost. See all the prestige I could have got. See the high position I could have attained to. See this one that I could have got. And I just rejected them. I rejected them. I hope those things will come. I don't care whether it is Satan. I don't care whether it is idol worshiper. I don't care whether it is the world that gives it to me. If it comes now, I'm going to take it. I'm not going to be foolish anymore. That's unbelief.
Àìgbàgbọ́ ni mọ́ mú yàn sórí kọ́ máa sunkún àbámọ̀ pé àbẹ́ àwa irun tí mo fi ṣe ra mi báyìí. Èmi tó jẹ́ pé wọ́n fẹ́ fún mi ní irú àǹfààní báyìí mo kọ̀ nígbà náà. Wọ́n fẹ́ fi mí fún sípò báyìí mo kọ̀. Tírù nǹkan báyìí tún bá wá sí ojú ọ̀nà mi. Ìṣe ni máa tẹ́wọ́ gbà àbí ẹ̀wárí bí mo ṣe wá lọ yan ọ̀nà àbòsí báyìí. Àìgbàgbọ́ ni mọ́ mú yàn ronú irú nǹkan bẹ́ẹ̀.
Hebrews chapter 11 from verse 24 again.
Hebrew orí kọkànlá láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹrìnlélógún
lẹ́kọ̀ọ́ sí. By faith Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter.
Nípa ìgbàgbọ́ ni Mose nígbà tí ó dàgbà ó kọ̀ kí a máa pe òun ní ọmọbìnrin Pharaoh.
Choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season.
Ó kúkú yàn àti máa bá àwọn ènìyàn Ọlọ́run jìyà ju àti jẹ fàájì ẹ̀sẹ̀ fún
ìgbà díẹ̀. He was ready to suffer with the people of God.
Ó múra tán láti jìyà pẹ̀lú àwọn ènìyàn Ọlọ́run.
There are people today, once there's a little inconvenience, a little suffering in the church, in the district, or in the fellowship where they are, they run away. They say, sound doctrine, forget about doctrine, see my suffering. They say, you know, I about all your responsibility, in the irresponsibility. What are you talking about? Look at affliction. Look at suffering. Look at inconvenience. Look at conflict. I cannot stay anymore. I'm going to a particular place. But there's no sound doctrine there. You are talking of sound doctrine. I want to remove my problem. It is unbelief.
Àwọn ènìyàn kan tó bá dàbẹ́ pé nǹkan kù díẹ̀ káàtó tí ò bára dé nínú ayé wọn nínú ìjọ. Kí á ní irú àwọn ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ wọ́n á kúrò nínú ìjọ. Kí wọ́n á lọ sí sọ pé wọ́n á bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní sọ pé èmi ò lè farada gbogbo irú ìnira báyìí mọ́. Tí àwọn èèyàn bá sì wà ń bá wọn sọ pé o fẹ́ kúrò nínú ìjọ báwo ni ti ẹ̀kọ́ tó yè koro tó ń gbọ́ nínú ìjọ wá ní ẹ̀kọ́ tó yè koro wá ní sáà ń sọ yìí. Pé káyàn kúrò nínú wàhálà èmi ò lè farada gbogbo nǹkan wọ̀nyẹn mọ́. Tó bá tún sọ fún wọn báwo ni tojúṣe tó ń ṣe nínú ìjọ wá ní ojúṣe kẹ̀. Kí ni mo fẹ́ ṣe pẹ̀lú ojúṣe? Àní mò ń wá nǹkan tó máa mú gbogbo ìṣòro mi kúrò. Irú àwọn ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ wọ́n á kúrò nínú ìjọ láì bìkítà.
Choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season.
Ó kúkú yàn àti máa bá àwọn ènìyàn Ọlọ́run jìyà ju àti jẹ fàájì ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ fún ìgbà díẹ̀.
Esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt.
Ó ka ẹ̀gan Kristi sí ọ̀rọ̀ tí ó pọ̀ ju àwọn ìṣúra Egypt lọ.
That can only be done by faith.
Nípa ìgbàgbọ́ lèèyàn fi lè ṣe
léyìí. He put all the things he could have enjoyed in Egypt, he put it on the scale in the balance, then he put reproach of Christ, the reproach for the name of the Lord, he put it on the balance. He said this reproach for Christ is more valuable in the light of eternity.
O wa mu egan Christi o fi si ori osun miran o wa gbe yewo ri pe egan Christi o niye lori o ni lari o se pataki ju gbogbo awon anfani
riyan lo ko ni aye ra iwaju recompense of the reward
tori pe o nwo ere na.
You see in what Moses did,
o wa ri nti Moses se,
he demonstrated the faith that conquers the flesh,
o fi igbagbo to nsegun ara si oju
se, the faith that conquers the world,
igbagbo to nsegun aye
yi. He took a decision to refuse the pleasure of the flesh in Egypt,
o se ipinu lati ko igbadun ara sile ni Egypt,
to relinquish a high position in the palace,
jijo wa iko ti o ga sile ni aafin,
to renounce power in the greatest empire at that time,
o ko agbara eti o agbara ti o ga julo ni igba na sile.
He had the courage to be able to resist the pride of life,
o ni igboya lati doju ijako igberaga
aye, and to reject prosperity,
o si ko asiki sile,
that could have made him to be blind to the call of God upon his life,
iru asiki ti iba fo loju ti pe olorun fun aye re.
That decision was a decision of faith,
iru ipinu be o je ti igbagbo.
Living faith in God is the only thing that can make us to forsake the things of the world that the worldly people are holding dear and precious.
Igbagbo aye ninu Olorun o ni yo je ka ko gbogbo ohun ti o se pataki loju aye dawon eyan le kakiri.
He considered what God was offering to him,
o gba ohun ti Olorun fi fun,
and he knew that what God offered was infinitely superior, greater, higher in every way than the things that the Egyptians were offering him,
o si mo pe ohun ti Olorun fi fun ohun yi o ga o niye lori ju gbogbo awon nkan ta le fi fun ni Egypt
lo. Do you notice there's a negative part to the faith and a positive part to the faith?
Oh, I may pay awon ihan kan wa ti o da nipa igbagbo awon ihan kan si wa to da nipa igbagbo.
No one, it's not that it's not good, it's just a negative side of it and then a positive side of it.
Eyan ni pe ihan kan eti o bojumo ati ihan kan to ku die ka.
Number one, he was ready to suffer,
akoko ni pe o nfe lati jiya,
and then we're told he refused all the thing they were giving him from Egypt. That refusal, that's the negative part of the action and decision of faith.
A si wa so fun wa pe o ko gbogbo awon nkan ti fifun ni Egypt sile yen ni pe o ko iha ko kan mi si in ti a fifun ni Egypt.
And then we are told that he now chose the reproach of Christ,
as wa so fun pe o yan egan Christi.
He was living by faith,
o ngbe nipa igbagbo,
and he faithfully kept eternity in view.
Besi ni o gbe aye raye ka iwaju re nipa igbagbo.
This is what we find in the language and the action and decision of Ruth.
O ti a si ninu igbesi aye Ruth pelu ni
in Ruth chapter 1.
Ninu Ruth
orike ni, I'm sure you would have known the story. And she also needed to make a choice. She needed to take a decision.
Please
remember whatever you are going through today. There are people too that have gone through difficult times. There are people that have gone through periods of uncertainty. Why does God allow those conditions to come upon us? He wants to know what kind of decision we are going to make. And he wants to know what kind of man, what kind of woman we are. And it is a decision you take that will mark you out, whether you are a man of faith or a woman of faith, or whether you are a man of unbelief or you are a woman of unbelief.
And the
people who talk to you, and they are telling you to take this decision. The kind of decision they are telling you to take will reveal to you what kind of people they are. If they are telling you not to endure again, not to wait for God again, not to stay on the Bible again, not to believe in God again, if they are telling you, you are thinking about heaven, will you not enjoy life first? If they are telling you all these things that you are believing in the word of God, making life difficult for you, why don't you reconsider this thing? If they are telling you to avoid affliction, to avoid all the misunderstandings, avoid all the problems, and let life be easy for you, the kind of decisions they are telling you to take will show you the kind of counselors they are. Now let us look at Ruth chapter 1. Reading from verse 11. And Naomi said, turn again,
again, my daughters, why will ye go with me? Are there yet any more sons in my womb that they may be your husband?
Now me see we pay and your mother in me pada.
Turn again, my daughters, go your way. If I am too old to have an husband, if I should say I have hope, if I should have an husband also tonight and should bear sons, would ye tarry for them till they were grown? Would ye stay for them not from having husbands? Nay, my daughters, for it grieveth me much for your sake that the hand of the Lord is gone against me.
E pada eyin omobirin mi e ma lo nitori emi di arugboju ati ni oko bi emi wi pe ni emi ni ireti bi emi tile ni oko ni ale yi ti emi si bi omokunrin ni ale yi eyin a le duro de won titi won o fi dagba. Eyin le duro de won lai ni oko nda o eyin omobirin mi nitori pe inu mi baje gidigidi nitori yin ti owo Oluwa fi jade si mi.
And they lifted up their voice and wept again, and Orpah kissed her mother-in-law, but Ruth clave unto her.
Won si gbe ohun wa soke won si tun sokun. Orpah si fi enu ko iya oko re lenu sugbon Ruth fa mo.
And she said, behold, thy sister-in-law has come back unto her people, unto her gods, her idols. Return thou after thy sister-in-law.
Won si wi pe kiyesi orogun re pada si odo awon eniyan re ati sodo orisa re iwo pada tele orogun re.
The decision of Orpah tells us what kind of person she was.
Ipinu ti Orpah se o fi iru eniyan to je han.
No faith in God.
Ko si igbagbo ninu Olorun.
Could not see that God is in control of the situation.
Won me pe Olorun lo sakoso oro na.
The decision of Ruth shows us what kind of a woman she was.
Ipinu Ruth fi iru obirin to je han fun wa.
And Ruth said, entreat me not to leave thee.
Ruth si wipe ma se ro mi lati fi o sile.
Not to return from following after thee.
Tabi lati pada kuro leyin re.
For whither thou goest, I will go.
Nitori ibi ti iwo ba lo ni emi o lo.
For whither thou lodgest, I will lodge.
Ibi ti iwo ba si wo ni emi o wo.
Thy people shall be my people and thy God shall be my God.
Awon eniyan re ni yo ma se eniyan mi, Olorun re ni yo si ma Olorun mi.
Where thou diest, I will die.
Ibi ti iwo ba ku ni emi o ku si.
And there will I be buried.
Nibe ni a o si sinmi.
The Lord do so to me and more also, if God but death part thee and me.
Ki Oluwa ki o si se be si mi.
You can tell the kind of person she was.
He
said difficulties are there, but if God is there, I'm going to go through the difficulty.
Affliction
may be there, but if God is there, I'm going to go through the affliction. I cannot see now the possibility of getting married again, but don't worry about that. If God is there, He will perfect everything concerning me. The unknown uncertainty is in front of me. I've never been with you to that land, but go ahead, we're going together. If God is there, He will take care of me.
You are the one that have introduced
the God of Israel to me. Even though you are the same person now discouraging me to say go back, I'm telling you that I've opened my mouth to the Lord. Even though you are the one that encouraged me before and you are the one saying I should go back now, I will not listen to you. I'm going to listen to what you have said before. That consecration, I hold on to it. Where you go, I will go. Where you die, I will die. Your God will be my God.
You want the anina to of your Lord Israel, me. Nigba ti mi o ti mo sugbon ni isin to ti wa fi han mi mo ti mo bo tile je pe iwo kan na to wa su fun mi nipa Olorun Israeli lo tun wa mu ko mi laye je pe ki n pada seyin mo ti fi owo mi le ohun ele itule n o ni boju wa yin o tesi waju ibi ti o ba ku sile mi na o ku si ibi ti o ba n lo lati jo n lo.
I know what our country people are saying. I know that they are saying, I'm a widow at my young age. This new religion you have got, if it's a good religion, why will you be a widow at this age? I don't know about that. I'm not in the secret counsel of God. The secret things are hidden away from me, but I know that this God will be my God. I've made up my mind. I'm taking a decision of faith. Move on. We're going together.
Mo man ti awon ara ilu mi wi ipe iru emi ti mo je odomobirin o ni oko re nku rewe rewe ti mo wa wa le oko sugba yin o turun kankan lara mi tori mo mo pe Olorun alaye lo Olorun yin ibi ti o nlo igan laudi jo lo mo si mo pe Olorun yen yo gba isakoso aye emi tesiwaju ka jo ma lo.
What kind of Christian are you?
Iru Christian iwo
ni wa. What kind of decision are you taking?
Iru pinu wo ni wa.
Are you deciding by faith? Are you looking at the wind that is blowing? Are are you listening to the words of the people around you? Do you take firm decisions by faith? Are you rejecting the pleasures of the world? Are you refusing the prestige in the world? Are you renouncing all those things that they are telling you to come into the world to get from there? Or you having double mind whether to stay, whether to go? Are you afraid of suffering? Are you afraid of persecution? Are you afraid of misunderstanding? Are you afraid of what the people will say? Moses was not afraid. Ruth was not afraid. Paul was not afraid. All those people are in heaven now. They are in heaven because of the decisions they took when they were on earth. What decision are you taking today? Will your decision send you to hell? Will your decision make you to spend eternity with the devil? Will your decision make you to spend eternity with the demons? Will your decision make you to suffer forever and ever? Will your decision separate you from Christ? Will your decision make you to run away, running for food and running for garments and running for the Babylonian garments? Will your decision make you to ruin your life because of looking for money? Will your decision make you to abandon your family? Will your decision make you to divorce your wife? Will your decision make you to throw away your children? The poverty surrounding you, the affliction surrounding you, the misunderstanding surrounding you, the need and the lack surrounding you, the joblessness surrounding you, will it make you to take a decision that will ruin your life and go to hell? Are you bold in faith? Are you courageous in faith? Are you saying, I'm not looking at the things of the world? You're looking at Christ that is always before you. You set your eyes on things of eternal value. And you're depending upon the Lord. You say, come what may, I'm going to serve the Lord. I reject the prestige of the world. I refuse the privilege of the world. I renounce the power of the political world. I relinquish the position in the village. I resist the pride of life. I reject the prosperity coming from the devil. I reject the false miracles that is coming from the occult. I choose the Lord. I will stay with the Lord. Your decision today will determine what will be in life. Your decision today will determine how you'll be useful in the kingdom of God. Your decision today will dictate, will determine what will become of your children. Your decision today will determine what will happen to your family. Your decision today will make you know whether God will be your friend or God will be your enemy. Your decision will either rescue you from the hand of the devil or put you into the jaws of the lion. Your decision can make you to live. Your decision can kill you and destroy your life. Are you deciding for the Lord? Are you deciding for Christ? Are you deciding for righteousness? Are you abandoning the world? Are you separating yourself from the things of the world? Do you hold on to the things of eternity? Do you throw away the thing that the devil is presenting unto you? Are you fixing your eyes on heaven? Are you fixing your eyes on Christ? Are you doing like Moses? Are you doing like Paul? Are you doing like Ruth? Are you going to stay with the Lord till the very end? Or will you allow the pleasures of this world to take you away from the hand of the Lord? Ordinary food. That's what Esau chose. That's what Esau chose. And because of porridge, he lost the birthright. What decision are you taking today? Because of husband? Because of marriage? Because of the demand of the flesh? You are selling yourself to the hand of the devil. Hell will be terrible. terrible.
Oro apadi yo buru
jojo. You'll be regretting all eternity because of the decision of the flesh.
O le kabamo ni aye raye sori.
Why don't you separate from that worldly man?
Kilo de ti o ko ko raye ni.
Separate from that worldly woman.
O ko obere aye ni.
And take a decision.
Ki o si se ipinu.
And throw away the scholarship coming from the devil.
Ko si so anfani ti nbo lati odo
Emi. Throw away the accommodation coming from the herbalist.
Ko ko ile to nbo lati odo babalawo ko ko sile.
And you throw away the charm that is coming from the idol worshipper. Say, whatever I have, whatever I don't have, I'm going to serve this God. I will not allow the things of the world to make me to go to hell. Your decision today, your decision in life, will determine whether you'll be in heaven at last or you'll be in hell at last. God says, I put life and death before you. God says, I put good and evil before you. Decide, choose life. Choose life. That you may live. And that your children may live as well. Those innocent children of yours can go to hell because of you. Those innocent children of yours can miss heaven because of your decision. Think about it. Have mercy upon those children. Don't take any rash decision. Don't take any foolish decision. Don't take any carnal decision. Your decision can take your whole family to hell. Be wise and choose the way of the Lord. Whatever the shame and whatever the problem, the problems will soon be over. Stay with the Lord. Decide for the Lord. Choose the Lord. You'll be happy in eternity.